All right, are you ready for part two?
Here's our duck pool. The ramp going up to it has to have a little door so that we can close off the pool when we're gone. The ducks don't love that,
but it keeps them nice and safe when we are gone for the day.
Inside of the duck pond, we have lots of these lily pads, which help to kind of prevent algae from building up and creates a more natural ecosystem for the animals.
And then we created this deck so that we could come up on the deck and then sit and relax next to the duck pond and enjoy all of the animals playing on their playgrounds and splashing in their ponds. I don't get to do that very often though, but it's here if I ever want to.
The deck overlooks all three of our duck pools so that we can keep an eye on everyone when we're sitting up here and relaxing. That's our disabled ducks pool, some seating, and then our male ducks pool. So we have all three pools for all the ducks to be separated in a healthy way. Here are some of our roosters' cages, and then this big yellow house is Charlotte's house. This is Albie. Get it, Albie, get it. Okay, so let me show you guys Charlotte's house. So Charlotte's house is actually a dog cage set up with a canopy top for a roof and a wooden wall for the front. It's super cheap and affordable, and I showed you guys how to do it on one of my other videos and on our YouTube channel, so you can check it out if you want. So during the day, this is where the pigs get to play at, and this is where the male goats hang out at, and everyone gets to just run around in the outer fields and dig as many holes as they want. This lake is usually filled with water. It's dry season right now, and we're working on lining it so that it can always have water in it. So that's that back area right there.
This shipping container right here is where we store our extra hay and bedding at so it doesn't get wet. And then this is our horse barn.
And so we currently have 5 horses under our care.
But we are a sanctuary and a rescue, which means that we are always growing and expanding and taking on new animals. So I have big plans on how we're gonna expand our barn area. This is our peacock Priya. We just rescued her, and I have big plans on building a whole aviary area just for her too. So stay tuned for that. I'll do a future video introducing all of the animals because this one is more about just showing our barn and all of the space that the animals have. But this is Lily. She's sort of the reason why I started rescuing animals. So that's the barn and the pasture space. And as you come around the side of the barn, it all wraps right back around into the animal play area. We keep rooster cages over here, and we have this awesome military canopy net that helps to shade the yard. This is Albie's house. He gets lots of pillows and blankets and stuffed animals. He might look intimidating, but he's a total cuddle bug. That beautiful bougainvillea pathway leads back out into the horse barn. This is Charlotte's old house, which is now currently open for a new rescue. And then one of my favorite things in the yard, our chicken coop. We have this beautiful chandelier and mirrors and all sorts of stuff for stimulation. Lots of perches for roosting and seeding, little xylophone for some fun, and then these are their nesting boxes where they lay their eggs at. And that is the chicken coop mansion. If you want to watch the full tour with more detail, be sure to check out our YouTube channel for more.